Hey Babboos, this is Chari from Cheers Chari, India's first and only beer podcast. So as you guys know, we are doing this entire series on Grandparents Day, and this is the third podcast. The first one was in Jaipur, the second one we just did in Pune with a brigadier, retired brigadier, and the third one, now we are going to a Calcutta club. So this is Mrs. Krishna Chandar and her daughter Devjani. And they're going to tell us a little bit about their experiences with beer, especially auntie, because she's a grandparent. I'm going to give it all to her right now. Hello, auntie.
Hello.
How are you and how is the lockdown treating you?
Oh, Baba, it's very boring.
and you also told me that you don't have beer with you right now, so I think it's a complete tragedy.
No, not right now. Nowadays, I live drinking beer. Sometimes when I go to the club or to the party, I drink. Then in the house, I don't drink.
Okay. And when did you start drinking, auntie? Do you remember the first time you had beer?
No. Yes. After my marriage. Not before my marriage.
Okay. You had it with uncle?
Yes. When uncle was there, we used to go to the party. And uncle tell me that you should take beer or whiskey, whatever you like.
Yeah.
And I told, I prefer to take beer.
Okay. Do you remember, how did you feel when you first had few sips?
First time I felt little dizzy.
Okay.
Little, I don't like it. It's not tasty. It's very poor and that. After going there with uncle, going to the party or to the club, I used to it.
Okay. And what beer you used to have? What brand of beer? Any memories of that?
Most of the time, Indian beers is, I don't remember the name, but I like Heineken beer. Heineken beer.
Yeah, Devjani was telling me about some story about Heineken actually. Devjani, you want to say something?
Yeah, so I remember my uncle, you know, initially you wouldn't get these Heineken beers in India.
Mm.
So my uncle used to get them, you know, when he used to come down from US.
Mm.
They used to get the tin Heineken beer and, you know, they used to be there in the refrigerator.
Okay.
I still remember. And my brother and myself, I remember we were forcing my mother to let us drink once. My mother was like, no, you should not drink.
Huh.
And so Heineken used to be there in the refrigerator whenever uncles used to come down from the US.
Okay. And mom has some story about Hoegaarden as well. Auntie, what happened over there? I heard that some Hoegaarden beer got missing from the fridge.
Because we are very conservative family.
Okay.
But no one takes beer. My father-in-law, he attends party, but he don't drink.
Okay.
That's the problem. And so there's a friend, uncle's friend from USA, and when he comes down, his wife is very fond of beer.
Okay.
So she used to tell me, you drink. In the house, I'm not allowed to drink.
Okay.
So I used to tell her, in the house, I can't drink. If I go out, then I will drink.
You should just step outside the door and drink, actually. That's it. It's outside the house.
Yeah. So we put this
out. We are not allowed because my father-in-law is very conservative.
Okay, no, can't blame him for what he's.
So, used to go to Calcutta Club. My parents used to go to Calcutta Club. We used to go to Calcutta Swimming Club. And drinking was not like a taboo in those days as such. But yeah, it was part of fun, was good thing.
We had lots of friends. We used to have parties. We enjoyed that.
Yeah, and club culture is a very integral and a regular thing with Calcutta. You know, it's not something that you go out of your way. You know, I think everyone is attached to some club or the other, and beer comes along as well, or rather, they're waiting for you.
Yes, yes. Club culture is very popular in Calcutta. Hmm. I remember my father used to remove the glycerin from the beer and drink it, you know.
Oh, wow. How did he manage to do that?
I remember. He used to take out the glycerin and drink.
And, Andy, you should definitely have day after, which is International Grandparents' Day, you should get a grab of beer for yourself. If not, we are going to be having one for you.
Yes. I was telling her the other day, only yesterday I told her that wine shops have now come online. So I was telling her, do you want me to order beer for you? I will order 2-3 bottles. She was like, no, no, I don't want to drink right now.
Okay. There's something you, Devjani?
No, because, no, what happened? My daughter-in-law don't drink.
Okay.
My son drinks. If I drink, my daughter-in-law, that's why I said don't say anything.
She will feel left out. You know, that's why my mom doesn't want to drink.
No, she can have her choice of beverage, whether it is coffee or whether it is thumbs up or whatever.
But when she comes down to Bombay, we go out drinking once in a while, you know.
Okay. I also, you called it white beer, isn't it?
Yes.
White beer. No.
Amra jeta Leopold Khechilam, that was white beer. Mone ache?
Oh, I remember. But it's very nice. When I went to Kembur with you,
we had Deera then.
We had Deera.
Yeah. We had Deera then. And I also think we had Heineken.
Heineken is very good.
Yeah, that's something. Yeah.
Yes. And in my mona, there was a herbal beer, you know.
Where?
Which we had. Herbal beer, CSC pe chilo. CSC had herbal beer long time ago.
Okay.
Oh, I don't remember. I don't remember. Something Indian.
Budweiser chilo, tarpore Kalyani chilo, Black Label.
Yes. Ki baba baba kheto ami jani na ota khub very strong.
Can't remember.
And in your club, also, what kind of food you guys would pair up your drinks with? Yes, you were saying something, Devjani, about that masala thing or something like that?
Yeah, in Calcutta Club, we used to have a lot of special
food. Yes, lots of masala. It is very special. If you come to Calcutta, I will
share. And it goes very well with, it goes very well with beer.
Okay.
My father was also very fond of Reshmi kebab, so he used to order a lot of kebabs, especially Reshmi kebab. Yeah, but you know what, he used to like a little on the blander side, because Reshmi kebab is a little bland compared to your Shami kebab and all, so he used to like Reshmi kebab a lot.
Shami kebab is very good, isn't it?
I don't eat that, so I don't know, but yeah.
You don't eat. You
eat. I eat seafood, auntie, and then otherwise I'm a vegetarian.
Oh, you are vegetarian?
Yeah, I'm a vegetarian.
Mat khai. Fish was always there. But yeah, Reshmi kebab was a must on the table if my father was around and he was drinking beer. And it was mostly in the clubs we used to go and drink. So Calcutta Club still has this bar called... So Calcutta Club has two special bars. One is a ladies bar where if you want to enter...
Not ladies bar, only men's bar.
Men's bar, so only men was allowed to go and drink there. But we used to drink at the pub.
Okay.
At the veranda at the bar at Calcutta Club.
There are lots of
places.
Not the group drink part.
So yeah, you were not allowed to sit with the men and drink?
No, only one part of the club.
Okay.
Only one bar. So there were several bars.
Huh.
But only one bar was exclusively for men.
Okay.
Okay, but other bars were like for everybody.
Acha. Okay. And coming closer home.
Calcutta club don't allow children in the bar.
Okay.
After 18 years old, you can enter the bar.
Oh, nice. So there were some good rules also.
Yes.
Yeah, but Devjan, you definitely started very young.
No, but yeah. So we used to have, that's how even, you know, when my friends used to come over, so we used to have these New Year's parties up there in the terrace.
Okay.
Okay, so we used to have bonfire in the terrace, and my friends used to be there on New Year's Eve, and that's how we used to spend New Year's together. So, and we used to call in for biryani from Royal India Hotel, which is the oldest Mughlai hotel in Calcutta.
Okay.
And it's more than 100 years old or something like that, okay?
Mm.
So we used to call in from biryani from there, and it's very, very popular, that biryani, and it's yum. And we used to have beer at the terrace.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, so we used to have this bonfire and beer and friends, and we used to have music. And,
how amazing that would have been, yeah.
It used to be good fun, yeah. And only my friends, okay, so nobody would come and interfere or, you know, would tell us, now it's too late, stop partying and all.
Yeah, and then go back home. No moral policing happening there.
Yeah. And then we would, then after sometimes we would just go and, you know, doze off in our
respective homes.
Yeah. And my friends used to go home the next day. You know, with a hangover and all. But that's how it's.
Story of our lives.
Yeah.
There was this thing that you were mentioning. Sorry, Aunty, you were saying something.
Devjani is a member of the Calcutta Swimming Club. She is also a member of the Calcutta Swimming Club.
Ah,
she,
nice.
And my son, they are also a member of the Calcutta Swimming Club.
So when you go drinking in the club, night is much cheaper in Calcutta?
Any day, yeah.
Anywhere, it's very cheap versus going to a restaurant and also because you could lounge around for a long time.
Yeah, because you're members, so it's almost like being at home. Yeah,
members, so you can hang around, and so it's much better going to a club.
You were saying something yesterday, Devjani, about mom loving Ho Garden a lot, and there's a story behind it.
Yeah, so, you know, once when Ho Garden had launched in Bombay, okay, officially, it still hadn't come to Calcutta. So from Bombay, I had picked up some 6-7 bottles and took it home.
Okay.
Okay. And I remember in the night, my mother, my brother and myself, we were drinking, okay? And so we drank that night, and after 2 days, I said, okay, let's drink again. There are more bottles.
Next time, bubbles are again.
Yes. No, that's
the
matter. That is my problem.
I want to join you.
Okay.
So next day when we decided to drink again, not next day, after 2-3 days, we opened the refrigerator and we realized that none of the bottles were there. So my mother was like, they were really nice, so she had polished them off.
Fabulous.
that was once, and then, you know, we had cousins living next door to us.
Okay.
Okay. So cousins would come in and go, you know, and like, yeah, people would just walk in and walk out. Aise tha. You know, because our neighbors were our cousins only.
Yeah. So doors are always open, actually.
And if we got some nice exotic beers, you know, my cousins would come over and said, okay, just get it to the terrace. And it was one common terrace. Okay. So we would all go up in the terrace and we would drink in the terrace.
How amazing those times are, yeah.
My cousins are still very fond of my mother, okay? So they would come and say, Kathy, where is the beer that your daughter was talking about, or your son was talking about? We want to drink, you know.
Kathy is a cool aunt, no?
Yeah.
everyone used to ask me. I can mix it with everyone. I like them. And we used to enjoy. If they want anything, they can take and go.
Everyone likes to hang around a beer lover, you know.
Yeah.
Because there's lots to gain from them.
Yes. So
even, you know, even is Dada and all my brother-in-law, they are bigger than my husband. They used to come. We used to have party everyone.
So, yeah, you know what? Drinking was never a taboo in my family, in my mother's, my father's generation, okay?
Okay.
My grandfather was a little against drinking, but that was a very individual choice, okay?
Absolutely, yeah.
But my aunts and my uncles, my father, my mother, they
never enjoyed
had any reservations,
yeah.
Right?
So
when my, my brother got married and my sister-in-law came in,
okay.
So my sister-in-law doesn't like drinking, okay? That's her individual choice, you know. So my uncle was like, you know what, you have a drink now that you've become a part of the family. Let's say, I think it was
there's
the second or the third day after marriage, yeah.
Huh.
It was like, you know, let's say cheers and cheers to a good beginning. So my sister-in-law was a little taken back. She was like, no, I don't drink.
Huh.
And my uncle was like, okay, so on your behalf,
we will drink it, yeah. Uncle, this is peena hai.
So my sister-in-law was a little, taken back because the elders were asking her to drink and she was like, okay, should I?
Huh.
My brother was like, it's up to you. If you want to drink, you can drink. If you don't want to drink, you don't drink. That's up to you.
Either way, it's your choice, yeah.
Yeah, it's your choice.
It's fantastic. So on that,
isn't it vodka is very good, isn't it?
Absolutely. Any form of alcohol is good, but the best, of course, according to me, is beer. Each to his own. So that's it.
Shandy, she's just Shandy.
Oh, okay. That a lot of people start with that actually.
Yeah, my mother used to have a lot. My Muna used to have a lot of Shandy.
তখন বাবা ছিল আমাদের বন্ধু বান্ধব ছিল একটা আমাদের একটা গ্যাং ছিল আমরা সারাদিন পার্টি করতাম বিয়ার খেতাম আর তারপরে বাবার বাড়ি থেকে বন্ধু আসতো মনে আছে সেই হিরু তার বউ বাবা কি বিয়ার খেত সে আমাদের ফ্রিজে রেখে দিত আর আসতো খেতাম গান গান
What is it? You need to translate that, John.
So, you know what? My parents used to party a lot, you know.
Okay.
So, Calcutta in the 80s and 70s was fabulous.
Hmm.
Like people used to party at drop of the hat, okay?
Okay.
And there were house parties, there were club parties, you would go to Swing Cars, and you know, you would go to Mocambo, Peter Cat. These were some of the favorite joints.
Okay.
Since my grandfather was alive at that time, some of my father's friends insisted they would have cold beer, so they used to say that why don't you keep the beer in the refrigerator?
Okay.
So since my grandfather was around, my father used to say, no, don't keep the beer in the refrigerator because my...
That's the thing. On that very, very happy note, we're going to be signing off from this podcast. And Auntie, once again, a very happy International Grandparents Day. We are hoping to see you soon. And we are going to be taking you out for a drink as well. And of course, we'll have a podcast at that point of time too. Thank you.